Before I've talked to you about using a really accurate scale and skinfold calipers to measure your progress. Now, these are the best tools for an intermediate or an advanced bodybuilder to measure progress, but they're not the greatest for a beginner. In this video, I'm going to show you the best way for beginners to measure their progress in fitness. It's old school, cheap, and easy to do. First, let's talk about why these skinfold calipers are not a great idea for beginners. A lot of newcomers to fitness have high body fat, and even professionals have a hard time using these skinfold calipers accurately when your body fat's over 25%. The electronic body fat measures are typically wildly inaccurate, so measuring body fat is difficult when you're body fat is high, which typically is for beginners. The other problem is scales are notoriously bad too. Even if you have a really accurate scale like the balance beam scale I recommend getting, the heavier you are, the more your weight fluctuates from day to day with different sodium intakes. So couple the inaccuracy of the calipers with the problems of weighing yourself accurately, and a beginner to fitness who's overweight really has no good information to go on with those two. So how can a beginner measure progress? Well, what you need is this $2.50 measuring tape. They're used in sewing, so you can get them at fabric stores or online. They're really cheap, like $2-3. Now, the first thing people love to do is measure chest and arms. Let's talk about why we're not going to do this. When you are overweight, you've got fat in your belly, obviously, but you also store it on your chest and arms. Now, even if you're doing like a boot camp program and gaining strength and muscle at superhuman rates, if you're losing that body fat, your chest measurement and arm measurement is actually going to go down, even though you're gaining muscle and strength at superhuman rates. Measuring your chest and arms does not give you any useful information if you're losing body fat rapidly, and it needlessly demotivates you. So save measuring your chest and arms and legs until you're under, say, 14% body fat. Then you can start using the skinfold calipers and start measuring your body parts like chest and arms. So what do you measure? You're only going to be taking one measurement, and that's your waist. If your waist is getting smaller, if it's an inch smaller than the month before, it does not matter what your exact body fat is. It's clear that you're lowering your body fat. And if you're doing a boot camp type program, and in that same month you're able to do more push-ups and more pull-ups, you're getting stronger. So really, what more do you need to know? You're getting leaner and you're getting stronger. That's all you need to know. So let's talk about how we're going to measure our waist. The important thing is that you be able to measure your waist accurately. Meaning, if you measure it and then take it off and measure it again, you should be able to come within like an eighth or a quarter inch, like 5 millimeters, of getting the same measurement each time. You want repeatability so that you can compare your progress from one week to the next. Now, we're going to measure it two different ways. I've found the two easiest ways to get measurements. One is we're going to make our waist as small as possible. We're going to suck it in, and then we're going to measure at the narrowest point. So see, like right there is the narrowest point. So I'm going to suck it in as tight as I can, make the tape snug but not tight, and measure it. So that's how we're going to do the first measurement. Suck it in, measure it at the narrowest point. Now, the second way we're going to do it is probably better for people who are significantly overweight and have like an apple-shaped belly. We are going to stick it out as far as we can, and we're going to measure it at the biggest point, which is typically going to be the bump of your belly. So stick it out as far as you can and measure it that way. Again, practice till you can repeat it and get it to be the same measurement. So maybe for the first 2 weeks, do those measurements every day. It'll help you get the hang of it. And then after that, just measure like once a week. And that is an awesome way to measure the progress of your body fat. Waist measurement. I told you this was going to be old school and easy. The reason I love this method of gauging progress is that it's so simple and it makes sense. You know, if your waist is getting smaller every month, you are making progress. If you can do more pull-ups and push-ups than you could last month, you are making progress. Seriously, what more do you need to know? You don't need to know exact numbers. You just need to know if you're going in the right direction. And if those things are happening, you have charted a good course, you're holding it, you're doing awesome. That's all you need to know. That's it for this week. Alf Peter's 8.